All right, everybody, welcome back to Cinderella Phenomenon. It's Monday, and it's time for some awesome sus visual novels. And I know what you're thinking. She was going to play Zokidoki Literature Club first today. You would be wrong. I'm going to make you wait longer. Not much longer, I promise. It's just that this has gotten so intriguing that I was really excited to get back to it. After being saved by that redhead, whose name is Karma, and Waltz, the illusionist boy, I'm really excited to see where it goes. I mean, we woke up in a strange room. She's still confused. She's had a really bad day, but she kind of deserves a bad day. So let's go ahead and jump back in here and see what happens. Oh, and those little symbols on the main menu, I was right in assuming that they're different curses, but instead of princesses, it's like princes, you know, like different guys that you meet who also represent a different curse. Okay, so yeah, she just woke up in this room. Oh, you're awake. Where am I? Ah, well, this isn't my room. My hand flies to my chest. The little glass slipper hangs from my neck. Still here. Well, yeah, wasn't a nightmare, sweetheart. This is your punishment for being a real catch you next Tuesday. Everybody. Are you okay, miss? This girl is the maid that tore Dolores' dress, the one I fired for her clumsiness. Miss? To think that I would meet her again here, like this. Oh, and sorry about the raspiness. I don't know why my throat is so raspy this morning, but it is. I'm trying to keep it under control for you guys by drinking some warm coffee. Leave me alone. Gosh, she's still being so mean. I mean, after, like, everything she's been through so far. Right, of course. Here's some salve I made for you. It'll help with the pain. Now what? Haven't thought at all, have you, Ice Princess? You. Suddenly, there she is. Dolores stands before me with a snide smile, looking happy with herself. She is the cause of everything I have been through. All the pain, heartache, and hunger. It is her fault. I try to stand, thinking to give the witch a piece of my mind, but as soon as my feet touch the floor, pain shoots up my legs. I end up falling back to the bed. Ow! You should be more grateful to the girl who you just scared away. She's been taking care of you for the past 2 days. 2 days? I've been passed out for 2 days? I'm suddenly vibrating with anger. Remove the curse. Now. Huh. Do you think you can just command me to remove the curse in your best princess voice? What do you want? Gold? What I want is worth more than all the gold you could summon an Angiel princess. Besides, haven't you read your fairy tales? The caster cannot take a curse back. You need to focus on breaking the curse yourself if you want your life back. Mother burned the books before I could read more than one or two of them. I do not think either involve curses, just genies and trading away your voice for legs. Ah, it's good that you're awake, princess. Parfait. Should you really be up and about? Is she, like, sick or something? They seem like maybe they're buddies. Don't fuss. I'm feeling much better. Are you a witch as well? Oh no. My name is Parfait, and I am a fairy. A witch and a fairy in one room, being friendly with one another? Impossible. Well, they represent the duality of, like, each other, so it makes sense. These two have probably been friends for a long time. Oh, look at her face. You weren't expecting that at all, were you, princess? What is going on? I'm sure you have many questions, princess. How do you know I'm the princess? Don't be silly. She's a fairy. Of course she knows. I promise we'll do our best to answer your questions. I don't even know where to start. What would you like to know? Why was I cursed? I mean, it's pretty obvious, but for the story's sake, we'll do it. Seriously? You're really going to ask that? I wouldn't have asked if I knew the answer. You have such a temper on you. Very well, this one's got a simple answer. It's because you're a cold-hearted, cruel, wicked princess who deserves to be punished. Delora, a curse is the only way to force you to change your horrid ways. Delora, you could have put that more nicely. I'm pretty sure I was already being nice. Change? Why do I need to change? Are you completely unaware of how heartless you are to other people? The coldness you show to your stepfamily and your father? The way you treat Princess Emmeline? Why would they need to be treated any differently? You need to prove that you have some goodness in you, Princess, some smidge of kindness. Why? People only show you kindness when they want something from you. The instant they get what they want, they'll just throw you away. What else would you like to know? How do I break the curse? The necklace you've got is one of Cinderella's glass slippers. To break the curse, you must get the second slipper, complete the pair. And how do I do that? By doing 3 good deeds. What? It's a very easy thing to do. At least for someone who knows how to be good. 3 good deeds? What does that even mean? Jeez, Lucha is like, I don't know what good means. My mom never had any books with the words good in them in the house. I wouldn't even know where to start. Take heart, princess. Goodness is innate in everyone. Are you sure that's the case with this one? Delora, you're not helping. I'm a witch, and I think I have more goodness in my big toe than she has in her entire body. Now you're just being mean. For every good deed you accomplish, you will get a piece of the glass slipper. When you've gotten all 3, you'll complete the pair and the curse will break. Simple. I suggest you start by polishing that attitude of yours. What happens if I don't break the curse? I think you know the answer to that one already, Princess. Yeah, you're pretty stuck, Luchette, if you don't. Why are you working together? To answer that, we'll have to give you a bit of a history lesson. Oh, I've got this. Of course she does. She's like, I'm gonna sass my way through an explanation. Once upon a time, in a kingdom far, far away, there were 2 crystals. Dramatics aside, there is one crystal in the kingdom called the Crystallum Lucius. It is powered by happiness and love. The other is the Crystallum Tenebrarum, powered by fear and anger. The strongest of the witches is the Tenebrarum Bearer. The strongest of the fairies is the Lucius Bearer. Parfait is the Lucius Bearer. I take it Parfait's frail and sickly appearance are taken. Yeah. She is the strongest fairy? The Great War greatly damaged me. My powers are a fraction of what they used to be. And with no child, I have no successor to my burden. What does a bearer do? The bearers regulate the energy of the crystal and keep the balance between darkness and light. For centuries, the fairies and witches lived in harmony with the humans of the kingdom. Until a certain human decided to be a pest. Who was he? I knew him as Hans Gabriel Grimm. Oh, Grimm's fairy tales. He wrote the fairy tales. Ugh, it's all his fault. Ugh. I have 2 Grimm's fairy tale books. They're freaking awesome. And he started the feud between the witches and the fairies in the process. How could a single person have so much power? It was the power of his words. In Grimm's stories, the witches were always evil. The humans naturally grew to fear and hate them. They began to hunt them. Didn't the witches fight back? We aren't allowed to use our powers to cause harm. But that all changed when the Tenebrarum Bearer decided revenge was more important than our promise. The witches took over the kingdom. They created the fairytale curse to spread even more sadness and anger to fill the human heart with negative emotions. All to fuel the power of the Tenebrarum. The delicate balance of harmony between the crystals was broken. The witches and the Tenebrarum grew far stronger than they were ever meant to be. We had no choice but to fight. And then the Great War happened. The Tenebrarum Bearer was eventually defeated. The Great War was ended with the help of an unexpected ally, but I wonder if the Tenebrarum Bearer was Luchette's mother, and that's why she disappeared. Many lives were lost. The good witches suffered horribly. We still have to stay hidden in hopes of having any kind of peace. Are you trying to make me believe that there are good witches? The Tenebrarum can poison a heart and mind into darkness and cruelty. The witches put themselves at risk in working with the Tenebrarum and maintaining harmony. Some, inevitably, are corrupted. Many good witches were corrupted during the war. Most remain that way. Many do not believe it, but witches can be just as kind as fairies. And yet, it wasn't a fairy that cursed me. I've done good by cursing you, Princess. You'll thank me when you've broken it. Delora was not corrupted by the Tenebrarum. She is as good as they come. Hopefully, you'll come to see that for yourself. I doubt it. Apart from my own inherent goodness, Parfait and I are working together because we have a common goal, which is to restore the balance between darkness and light. 3 good deeds and I get my life back. Easier said than done. You said Cinderella, didn't you? Didn't she just go to a ball and find a prince? What does doing good have to do with that? Going to a ball, finding a prince, it's all so old-fashioned. No fun in that. Cinderella is a girl with a pure heart. She's always willing to help others, even when they are cruel to her. Anyway, I have brought some clothes for you. I'll leave them on the table. We'll be waiting outside. There are some people I'd like you to meet. I cannot believe this. I look down at my neatly bandaged feet. I have to admit that while sore, they are nowhere near as painful as they had been 2 days before. Here's some salve I made for you. It'll help with the pain. Why would she even care? I was the reason she lost her job at the palace. Oh, she probably doesn't remember me as the princess. But still, she has no reason to do such things for me. I ignore the salve for the time being and gingerly stand up, testing my feet for pain. The injury is definitely healing. I slowly walk over to the table and change into the clothes that have been left there. The dress is nowhere near as luxurious as the ones that I wear in the palace, but still it is far improved from my rags. All my life, I've never had to lift a finger. And now? I will not let them see how much they have rattled me. I refuse to break. Just watch me. I will free myself from this curse. What is this place? There are several people in the room chatting amiably with each other. I notice the girl that had left me the salve by the counter, serving drinks. But as soon as the people in the room notice me, the room falls into immediate silence. Well, look at what we have here. The Ice Princess herself. Huh? They know who I am? I didn't think it was true. Curse for her cold-heartedness. As to be expected. You remember who I am, and yet you still treat me like this? Well, you aren't really a princess anymore, are you? You're one of us now, girl. Everyone, please, you shouldn't be treating a newcomer like this. Princess, let me apologize. They mean no offense. I cannot believe that. Not when the people Parfait is referring to simply smirk and shrug as I meet their gazes. What is this place? Welcome to the Marchin Tavern. A home for those with the fairy tale curse. You make it sound like some kind of holiday house. Don't ruin my moment, Delora. Marchin? Tavern? The Marchin was built 3 years ago when the number of cursed in Angiel continued to rise. The goal is to gather those affected so they might help each other break their curse. Of course, I am also here to provide help as necessary. Only the cursed and those allied with our cause can stay here. The evil and the wicked could never find this place. Most of the people here are cursed. How come these people remember who I am? The cursed are not affected by the conditions of someone else's curse. Your condition is simple. Everyone has forgotten you are the Crown Princess. But because these people here are cursed, they still remember your title. It goes without saying that fairies and witches are also not affected. Come, Princess, let me introduce you to the few boarders we have at the Marchin. Parfait beckons the serving girl. This is Anise. She helps out in the Marchin and does most of the cooking. I'm sure you understand why she's working here now. I believe she deserves an apology. Miss Delora, what are you talking about? Don't you worry your sweet little head over it. You don't remember what this Ice Princess did to you. Huh? I have nothing to apologize for. Clumsiness does not befit a palace maid. I only did what was necessary. Well, it's nice to meet you, Princess. I'm Anise Willow. I hope you get along. Chet, don't be so mean. Really? This is how you're going to start doing good? I don't believe I asked for your opinion. Please, you two, no fighting. I hold my tongue as Parfait leads me to two people whose faces are incredibly familiar. They are faces I have seen in the palace before. This is Jurien Valente and Garland Bellero. Hello, Bellero. Jurien. How did you know? Both of you are in the Order of Caldera. That's right. They were two of Sir Alcaster's best knights. It was a big surprise when they both left a year ago. I only found out recently that it was because they acted against Sir Alcaster's orders. They were stripped of their titles and dishonorably discharged from service. What are you two doing here? We help the fairies. Well, I guess that's a girl. I gave her Jurien's voice. They and Anise are exceptions, and are allowed in this tavern without the curse. Jurien and Garland lend us their strength to help protect the Marchen. Protect? From the witches. They do anything to make sure their curses remain unbroken. And what about you? I am an exception. Also, I'm good. You keep forgetting the good part. Remember, not all witches are evil. Your curse is a test. A test? Originally, the wicked were cursed so that they could learn to change. Their curses were meant to teach them a lesson. I'm hoping your curse will teach you a lesson too, Ice Princess. I really am only trying to help. I don't need you to show me how to change. I just want my life back. Well, to do that, you'll have to break your curse. Try and make some friends, Princess. They might be able to help you break your curse. Oh, I'd love to hang around and watch the princess try to be friendly. We have work to do, Delora. Fine. Try not to make any more enemies, Princess. The instant Parfait and Delora leave the room, the temperature drops several degrees. Now that I am alone, I feel the cold stares return. Disgust. Contempt. As if I am the reason they are cursed and have to take refuge in the Marchen in the first place. Make friends? All I've ever had are my dolls. I've never needed friends. I will break this curse on my own. I was told it was rude to stare. One man suddenly stands up, the anger apparent on his face. And we will find out why he's so angry next time. I'm sure there's some, like... She's done so many mean things to so many people that I don't even know how, like, she's gonna find redemption for her freaking salty... cold, just crappy attitude towards everyone in existence. Like, she's just so mean. I also think sometimes she reads too much into things. Like, she always talks about how people look at her, like, with anger and coldness and how much they hate her. And it's like, I don't think everybody does. I just think it's the people that she's done mean things to. But we'll find out what happens with this Brosif next time. Tomorrow. And I hope you guys are liking this. It's really starting to get exciting. Now we're in this Marchen tavern with all the other cursed people, or with a lot of the cursed people. So, yeah, I'm pretty excited to see what happens. I'm really excited to see where, like, all the cursed princes and stuff come in, and how we're gonna break our curse, which avenue we're gonna take. I think I'm actually going to try and meet every one of them. Each story for each different cursed prince, just to see like how it goes. I don't know if you guys want to see that or not. I mean, let me know in the comments if you would like me to do all the prince's stories, or if you just want to see one. You know, I don't really mind. I'll probably do it anyway, but I love you guys, and I will see you over in Doki Doki Literature Club. Bye!